These are the ingredients: 12 grams of salt, 700 grams of flour, 450 grams of warm water, 8 grams of dried yeast. Dried yeast goes into the water like that. Quick stir. Half the flour. We'll just stir. Put the rest of the flour in. Salt on the flour. And just leave that for 10 minutes. What I'm just going to do is take that over to the mixer. Just going to leave that for 10 minutes. Mixer in. That's the 2 minutes. I'm going to turn that on slow. And that's just going to incorporate. This is not quite up to a minute. Right, we're just coming up to 2 minutes. 9, 8, 7, 6. That's how it's looking. Right, so we're just going to increase the speed a bit. I'm going to leave that for 5 minutes. Should come up to 5 minutes. Leave that to rest while I just put the machine away.
There's the dough.
That's just a little bit of water. So, I'm going to make sure that my hands are just damp, but they don't need to be too damp. So, just, and all you do is you indent that and make it into a square. Release one edge and just make sure it's released. Stretch it over like that. Just moisten the hands. Indent 90 degrees. Pull over. This dough is quite sticky. Just moisten. Indent. Ninety degrees, stretch over. Indent. Ninety degrees, stretch over. Release it all the way around, and then you're trying to pull it and make it into a ball. That's it. So basically, I've got my bowl, got my bowl, put them in the bottom, put the plate on top, and we'll put that away for 30 minutes. Right, that's what it looks like after 30 minutes. I'm going to turn it out onto the 30 minutes exactly. Just loosen it from the sides. Empty bowl. Right, dry hands, just a little bit of moisture, just a few drops, that's it. Then a bit more indentation. Right, spatula, loosen from the work surface and just pull over like that. Very small amount. 90 degrees. Pull over. As you can see, it's getting a little bit of structure. Last one. Right. And then all you do is pull it into a ball, rotating it as you're pulling it. There you go. Rotation, pull. Rotation, pull. 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 Put that in the bowl. There she is. You'll see it in 30 minutes' time. Right, this is 30 minutes. That's what it looks like, nice and risen. So we're just going to take that out of the bowl onto the work surface. Always be very gentle with the dough. So, give it some indentation, release from the work surface, and pull it over. The dough is actually slightly less sticky. Right, pull it over that way. And one last fold. Right. Pull it into a ball. Last 30 minutes. Right, that's the end of the third rise. So I'm just going to take it out of the bowl. You can see it's a nice ball. going to divide this into four. This is a floured couche. Let the knife. So I can cut it. Look at that lovely dough. Right, I'm just going to dab it on the couche. Put it on the scale. It's 235, so it's a bit light. 216. 217, probably. Dab it on the couche. 13, that's a bit too much.
Oh, morning.
Morning.
How
just doing a video.
Oh.
Yeah, I've just got your egg to do.
Okay, yeah, no.
22, that's good. So, there we four. So basically, fold it over once towards you, bit of flour, and fold right over, bit of flour, the other hand, just seal it up, tuck it in. Roll forward, roll over, just seal it up, tuck it in, just make a little torpedo shape. Roll it with the flour. Make a square, roll forward towards you, roll against it, the opposite way, just seal it up. Tuck in the ends. A bit of flour. Right, last one. Little square. Roll forward towards you. Roll the opposite way. Roll it over. Tuck in the ends. Seal down. Tuck in the end. Seal down. So we've got four torpedoes like that. Water out of the way. Floured couche. Just give it a cover. Like that. 15 minutes. Right, we've set the timer going for 15 minutes. And while doing that, I've got the oven on absolute maximum. So anyway, I'll show you what I've got in the oven. In the oven, I've got a metal plate. I'm just going to take that out. It shouldn't be hot. And then this stone, it's a piece of marble. It's just a flat piece, square piece of marble in the top. So, take that out and show you. This is just a flat piece of 3mm thick steel. And this is just a piece of marble. Just sits in the oven like that. We're also going to put a very heavy cast iron frying pan in the bottom, dry. Leave that to heat up. Basically, all I do with this piece of steel is wipe it down, smear it with a bit of oil. I put my baguettes on that, slide it with cold, slide it into the oven. And then the heat from the stone goes straight through that and it springs the baguettes up.
Right, uncovering the floured couche. Just put it on the side there like that. It's well floured. Keep your hands roll the dough over towards you, then fold it all the way back and use the heel of your hand or the side of your hand, tuck the edge in to seal it over. Seal it over. Seal it over. Seal it over. Make sure it's well sealed. Just check there, like that, and then put it on the couche and just roll that up like that. We're doing that for the other three. Roll forward towards you, two thirds, roll it over, press and seal, tuck in, fold over, fold over. Fold over, fold over, tuck in, seal. Check they're all nicely sealed. And that goes back on, that goes on the couche as well. Right, last two. Fold two thirds towards you, two thirds towards you. Fold over, press and seal, just tuck the end in, seal, just work your way along. And tuck the final end in. Check they're all sealed properly. Put on the couche, just rush it up like that. Sticky. You don't want a lot of flour on it because you need the dough to stick. Fold over, tuck in, fold over, fold over, fold over. Nice and sealed, seam side down, and then cover that completely over.
And there you have it, and very little mess. Leave them for 30 minutes now, and then we'll pop them in the
right,
oven.
While the oven's warming up, just a spot of olive oil on the piece of steel, and just give that a wipe over. That just stops the baguettes sticking whilst they're cooking to the metal. That job's a good one.
Right, that's oiled. So basically just uncover. Look at them bad boys.
So just roll out the baguettes, you can find where the seam is and put them on the tray. Evenly spaced.
Right. A little bit of oil in your hand.
I'm going to do it. I'm going to slash these parallel diagonal lines along the length of the baguette. I'll do three. It's a little bit wonky. Straighten her up. Lovely. So, I'm just going to put them over by the oven.
Just give these a little spray of water on the top, just to help with the spring.
Now, if you notice, I'm wearing decent gloves. These go straight in. Keep low. Boiling water. Straight in there. 8 minutes.
And then just turn the heat down to 200. So it's been at 250, taking it down to 200. And they're just nicely, and they're springing already. So while I'm letting the oven do in, I'm just showing you my couche. All it is a pillowcase. I just spread some flour on, just rub it in lightly. There's not a massive amount. You can just see it just slightly dusty. That's absolutely invaluable. Keeps all the flour in one place as well. Sorts the baguettes out, and that's it. Keeps everything neat and tidy.
Right.
Watch out for steam.
Look at these bad boys. I'm just giving them a quick turn so they're evenly cooked. Another 8 minutes.
Right, we're coming up 19 seconds to a further 8 minutes. They are cooked now, but this is where you tweak them. I like them really nice and browned and crusty. So what I'm going to do is swap the light bits for the dark bits, just swap them round so they evenly cook. Check the frying pan, there's no water in it. There we go. Watch the steam. So look, I'll swap that one for that one. Right, look at the bottoms on that, fantastic. Lovely. So put that back in. Take that out, a bit of water in, I don't want any of this in. I'm just going to crank it up another 30 degrees, so it's 230, put it on for 3 minutes, and then I shall just flip them round after 3 minutes, just to make sure that they're evenly browning. One second, there we go. Check these out. Lovely, we're going to flip round. I think another 2 minutes. Right, let's see if we can get these out. Yeah, I'm happy with them, so I'm just going to put them on the side. And that's how they turn out like. Slightly flat on the bottom, but not bad. Right, just so you can hear them, check them out. Lovely crackle, straight out the oven. That's how they like. And here we all are, enjoying a sunny day with the bread. Just cut it. That's it. Yeah, that's got a nice crust on it.